next guest is running to unseat Ilhan Omar and is here with a message for both Congresswomen. Lacey Lee Johnson joins us now. Lacey Lee, thanks so much for being here. What is your message?
Well, my message is that we do not want a representative in Congress like Ms. Omar, that the government of Israel was well within its rights to deny her, and it's expected that they would do that. Ms. Omar has openly called for the boycott, divestment, and sanctions of the nation of Israel. And as such, she has basically made herself an enemy of that nation or enemy of the state. And no country that I can think of would let an enemy in. The other thing that's not being reported, I guess, on a large scale basis, that basically Mr. Netanyahu, they saw her itinerary. It had nothing to do with humanitarian reason. It had to do with her continued support of the BDS movement. And it also had to do with her delegitimizing the state of Israel. So they rightfully decided that they were not going to let her enter. The same thing goes to the other Congress lady. She was not there to see her mom. Once they saw her itinerary, they knew exactly what she was there for.
Grandma, right.
And so she's trying to, she's trying to change the narrative now. But that's basically what's going on here, and what people need to know. And Israel is well within its right to deny her that entry.
What really stood out to me, sir, is that you heard a number of Republicans, even AIPAC, saying Israel should let these folks in. And then, to me, like I said earlier, I felt that they were winning the PR narrative on that point. And when the grandma stuff happened, I felt like they completely lost that. My question to you is, do you think the nation sees that switch in the PR narrative? And specifically with regard to the race you're running, do you think that they're going to tie Omar to Tlaib and give you a win there in Minnesota?
Well, Minnesota is a basically liberal conclave here, especially in the metropolitan area. It's going to be tough, but we plan to pull it off. But as far as Mrs. Omar and her looking at Israel, we are here to run against her, to stop those type of things, to stop the embarrassment. Basically, what she's doing is trying to be an international celebrity rather than concentrating on the needs of her people. Mrs. Omar lives in a district where the black population has a poverty rate of 40% of the blacks are below poverty. She has not done anything about it. She's not proposing to do anything about it. There's other issues as far as crime and violence and things that's going on in this district that she has not addressed, and that's why I'm running against her to stop this. Bait and switch.
Lacey Lee Johnson, we're going to be monitoring your race, of course, throughout the course of the next year or so. We wish you the best of luck, and we'll see you soon.
Thank you.